Hello and welcome to TPM's 3-Minute Thursday. Today's an old trick that I used to love to show during sheet metal classes, and that's adding patterned holes across sheet metal bends. So lots of times we want to have holes that cross over bends, such as this park bench here, and it's just something that we show in our sheet metal classes. It's very, very simple to do, but a lot of people kind of forget that it's there. So how do you do it? So what you want to do is get your basic sheet metal done and then start unfolding it. Now don't use flatten, because then those features will show up only post-flattening. You want to show these in the folded state. So we want to use our unfold and fold tools. So look for those. You've got unfold and fold. So I've already got this unfolded, and we're also going to use this little slot feature that I have for mine. Now, you can use some basic shapes, squares, holes, polygons, and such, but I'm going to use the slot. You want to go to your patterns and find what's called a fill pattern. Now, once you get into the fill pattern, it's just a matter of telling it what's my boundary. So in this case, I'm going to select faces. If you had a sketch to define as a boundary, say an ellipse where you want to put some vent holes on the side of a housing, then draw in the ellipse as a sketch. Here I'm just going to let it fill the entire face. All right, now you can see it's already picked up my slot, and then what I want to do is define the pattern layout underneath. So we can do this in circular, square, perforated, or polygonal. All right, and then just define your spacing. Now if you go really, really tight spacing, you're going to get a lot of holes, and this is where performance really starts to be taxed. All right, I'm just going to leave this as a 2-inch spacing. We can control the angle that we want to show the stagger in. All right, and then also if we want to have any kind of margin. So if I remove the margins, you can see it goes all the way out to the edge. Probably not a good idea here, so we're just going to leave a 2-inch margin and keep everything inside of the outside boundary. Now this is something new I haven't seen in a while, is instance count. So we used to not have this, and SOLIDWORKS added this recently. So now as you add faces, you're gonna see this value start to really, really grow. So I'm already over 1,000 holes. Now you can only imagine what patterns are like when you get this big. So you wanna be really careful on your spacing here. So after this, just hit OK and let it run. It does take a little while to run this, so be patient. Once it's done running, then all we want to do is come in and add our fold operation. We'll go ahead and let it collect all the bends and then fold this up. And again, the fold operation will take a little while as well. In fact, if we look at the feature statistics, we can see that we've got some pretty big rebuild times, and the fill pattern and the fold both eat up pretty much almost 100% of the rebuild time. So be careful of that. But once you've got it done, you've got yourself a nice nice set of holes across bends, and you're on your way. And that's been TPM's 3-Minute Thursday. We'll see you next time.